truffles last week. Bloody lovely they were.
I polished them right off.
Neat. Thanks. It's been a pleasure, guys.
Don't mention it.
I just noticed a sign. It says fruit for sale, Roman numeral 4.
I've heard of these guys. They stock all sorts of fruit and have one of the largest ranges of illegal spice in all the Four Kingdoms. Hey, guys.
You again.
What'll it be, lad?
I've got a few questions, if you wouldn't mind.
Ask away.
Thanks. It's been a pleasure, guys.
Don't mention it.
Never mind.
I've heard of these guys.
Hey, guys.
You again.
What'll it...
I've got a few...
Ask... Thanks. Don't...
Ouch. I think his leg is broken.
You can actually hear him say things, like, normally now.
Please, sir. Spare me a penny.
If I was a needle, this is where I would hide. Not got much use for a handful of hay.
Or the assassin, or the gardener.
Poor fella. Lost his eye clipping shrubs in the castle garden. Grass snake jumped and bit him right in the peeper. Now he keeps just turning away at that soil, day and night. Soiled snake, they call him.
Soiled snake.
Excuse me, sir. I'd like to ask you a few questions.
Right, well, make it quick.
We can actually talk to him now. What are you up to?
So, what are you up to?
Just turning the soil, ready for planting.
Oh, I think it's been turned enough.
Oh no, you see, it's gotta be real nice and fluffy, like a cloud. A black, thunderous cloud torn against the night sky.
Oh.
Weird.
I like your eye patch.
I like your eye patch.
Thank you. It's become as much a part of me as the skin on my bones.
Do you ever take it off?
The world isn't ready to see the horror forsaken upon me.
Oh, right.
Please, do not pity me. Save your apathy for my brothers.
Your brothers?
Your brothers.
The Sons of Liberty.
Oh, the Sons of Liberty.
Was my mother, a kind woman with a heart of gold. Widowed and left to care for triplets. Eli, George, and I, David. Despite our differences, my brothers and I worked hard to make a name for ourselves. Before long, our agricultural activities had earned up quite a desirable reputation. We clipped shrubs for the King and Queen of Westbridge, cultivated fruit for the Duke of Davner, and of course, tended the flora at the Castle Wrinklewood.
That's where I live.
Aye, a place I have not stepped foot in for 20 years.
Wow. That is a long time. So, why'd you stop working at the castle?
It's dangerous work being a groundsman. You never know what might be lurking behind a begonia.
Isn't that the truth?
We were young and careless. We had no idea such slithery beasts lurked behind those walls. I still remember the look in their eyes. As the scaled beast whipped its twisted toils around their necks. And just like that, the Sons of Liberty were no more.
That's so sad.
I will never forget that morning.
So, why the eye patch?
Oh, right, one of the snakes bit me, you see.
Ah, of course, yep.
I thought that was obvious. Maybe I need to work on the delivery.
Well, I'll be seeing you.
Right you are.
His belly button moves from side to side sometimes, I just noticed it.
Excuse me, sir, I'd like to ask you a few questions.
Right, well, make it quick.
Seen anything suspicious lately?
Seen anything suspicious lately?
Not since last time you asked.
Oh, well, keep your eyes peeled.
Never asked.
Stop bothering me, would
you? Oh, you don't want to say that.
Well, I'll be seeing
you. Right you are.
It says, no dancing in the fountain! Of course, signs like these don't apply to guards like me. Not got any use for a sign about dancing. Thanks to Wrinklewood's unique location, we can have lavish water features like this one.
No more coins, right?
There were no coins left to take. A table, sticky and featuring several crude carvings. I think that's a cat playing keyboard. Definitely too big for me to move.
That's also another table?
A table. I think that's... Once, the handle fell off. 2 weeks we were stuck in there with nothing but double-salted peanuts and bourbon. Best 2 weeks of my life. Ah, the drunken monk. If wolves could speak, they'd have some stories to tell. She's like a mother to me, in many ways. Woke up there 3 years ago and I can't remember a damn thing before it. Sam's completely useless trinkets. Well, at least she's honest about it.
Now she can actually understand us. But we still can't buy anything here.
A big old anchor. They use these for tying down ships so they don't float away. Can I have this?
Sorry, mate. Display purposes only.
Drat.
Tough luck, kid.
Hmm.
Yuck! It's a half-eaten, slightly rotten sandwich. I really don't want that.
Can't say I blame you.
So it's not the same thing over and over again where he says he wants this and it's for 30 coins.
It's an ornate goldfish on a string. There's a big circular opening in his mouth. That's a lovely looking fish. What's it do?
One of our luxury items. They say it leads the way to an ancient city buried deep underwater.
Oh, I'm not sure I have time for an adventure of that scope.
I'm not sure you have the coin.
It's 30. Melted mug.
A half-melted mug filled with a foul green liquid. I've not got much use for a melted old mug.
The necklace made out of eyes.
Is that necklace made of eyeballs? Probably some black magic nonsense. The kids are really into that stuff. So, what's with the creepy necklace?
Ooh, the whole thing. Well, it's said to be all that remains of a great explorer. An eye that has seen the world.
And the other, eyeballs?
Most likely just decorative.
Can I have it?
Can't let it go, I'm afraid. Besides, I've become kind of attached to it.
Yeah.
Either a child's toy, or the land's worst taxidermy. Your guess is as good as mine. What about that fluffy pig fella at the top? Poor thing looks petrified.
Ooh. No, sorry. I really shouldn't even have that one on display.
Why is that?
There's no time to explain. Can
really?
I interest you in anything else?
I like her voice.
I've never seen these before. You shove them in a tube and blow. That thing flies across the room at lightning speed. Pretty neat, actually. That blow dart looks neat.
The what now?
That feathered thingy at the top there.
Ooh, that. Been stuck there for years.
Doubt I could reach it anyway.
The stone discs?
3 stone discs, each with a hole in the middle. I wonder what they're used for. What about those old stone discs? What are they exactly?
Just another relic from an ancient civilization.
Well, can I have them?
Afraid not. Those are part of a set. Worth a pretty penny if you have all 4.
There's only 3.
Sure. Son, Mond, Vulcan, and Tiddlypeep. We're missing the Tiddlypeep.
Oh. I'm not sure that's right.
Can I interest you in anything else?
Yes, you can.
Looks like some sort of fancy teapot. Seems well buffed. What about that shiny teapot?
Ah, yes. The mystical lamp. One of a kind, that.
Can I have it?
Let me see. Straight out of luck, I'm afraid. That's one of our auction items. Unless you're happy to match the reserve price.
And how much is that?
A lot, I'm sure.
2,599 quid. Can I interest you in anything else?
Golden sticks.
Some kind of dried tree bark by the looks of it. Probably used for making potions and whatnot. Could I have this one?
You want those fancy smelly sticks? Let me see. Oh, I'm sorry. That one's a special order.
Well, can I have it?
Wouldn't be worth my skin. Looks like a Mr. G. Threepwood is coming to pick it up this afternoon.
Guybrush Threepwood.
Can I interest you in anything else?
Okay, so Guybrush Threepwood from the Monkey Island games is coming to pick that up. It'd be cool to meet him. I'm sure he's not going to show up, though.
Looks like some kind of fancy footwear in a strange, shiny green material. Could I have this one?
You actually want those? I mean, I hear they're the height of fashion in the South Shores. You get that fancy hat, too. Let me see.
It's like she's typing on a computer.
Oh, I'm sorry. It would seem those items have already been reserved. Looks like a Mr. M. Mayer is coming to pick those up tomorrow. Can I interest
Mayer.
You in anything else?
White glove.
It's a glove, that's for sure. Has a similar trim to the hat above. Could I have this one?
A fine choice. A luxury item for sure. One moment, please. Yes, those will set you back 50 quid for the pair.
50? That's a lot of money for a pair of hand warmers.
Look, they're genuine white leather. What did you expect?
I'm not spending a month's wages on a pair of gloves.
Can I interest you in anything else?
This.
I do believe that's what ladies' undergarments look like. They've got pretty little frilly bits around the bust. I'll take the brasserie.
And what exactly would you be
brassiere.
Planning on using that for?
I don't know. I guess it could come in handy.
Disgusting.
No, I mean, it's elasticated. Could have a whole number of uses.
Elasticated?
Yeah, sure it could.
I'm not sure what you're insinuating.
Well, it's not for sale and we'll leave it at that. Can I interest you in anything else?
This is an adventure game. You can use it for anything. Inkwell.
It's an inkwell. Used for holding ink and writing letters and such. Could I have this one?
You want to see that old inkwell? Let me see. Oh, I'm sorry. Unfortunately, that item is reserved. Could I interest you in something else?
A wizard's hat.
One of them dumb wizard's hats. They're really milking the cow with that one. Could I have this one?
Ah, the wizard's hat. Afraid I can't sell you one without a license.
A license?
I'm gonna assume you ain't got one.
Well, not exactly.
Sorry, chap. We can't sell enchanted items without proof of ID. Can I interest you in anything else?
Yikes! There's a hand in that jar! Ugh, not sure I want that.
That one's a return item. Customer wasn't too happy with it. That's why it's just half the price. For a limited time only.
You couldn't pay me to take that away.
Right you are. Well, can I interest you in anything else?
What a peculiar looking headdress. Has a hole right in the middle. Its trim matches the glove below. Could I have this one?
You actually want those? I mean, you get the fancy... Let me see. Oh, I'm sorry. Looks like a Mr. M. Mayer. Can I interrupt?
Actually makes me think of it like a Mickey Mouse.
Some kind of stuffed children's toy. Is wearing a tiny novelty hat. Could I have this one?
A fine choice. A lovely gift for a younger sister or granddaughter, perhaps?
Granddaughter?
This particular item was handmade, stitch by stitch, by a very talented toy smith. Looks like you're in luck. We have two of these in stock at the moment.
That's great!
Of course, quality needlework comes with a price.
Sure
does. A child's happiness is priceless.
Do I look like a charity? 50 quid.
Oof.
Can I interest you in anything else?
A pair of flintlock pistols embossed with a floral design. I wonder if they still work. Oh, can I have those?
Afraid not. Those are for display purposes only.
Oh, do they work?
Couldn't say. They've been here since I took over the shop.
So they might work.
Look, I'm not about to sell firearms to a minor.
I'm 24 and a bit.
Can I interest you in anything else?
Huh.
A minor? You just thought he might have a granddaughter.
Looks like some kind of petrified bird. Probably stuffed. I'll take that funny-looking petrified bird.
A fine taste in avian decor. They get their colour from a natural diet of brine shrimp and blue-green algae.
Sounds tasty. How much?
Let me see.
Sounds tasty.
Oh, my mistake. That item's on back order. Seems like a Mr. R. Wind has that particular item reserved.
Rincewind.
Can I interest you in anything else?
Rincewind from the Discworld games.
A beach bonnet, often worn by the elder citizens to hide the sun from their face. This one has a nice pink bow. What a fine looking bonnet. Can I have it?
Well, don't you think something less pretty would be more suitable?
But I really like the bow.
I can't say you're exactly the target demographic, but let me check. Oh, silly me. That one's not even on the stock list. The bonnet belongs to one of our senior citizens. She brought it in for repair a few weeks back. Strange. She should have collected it by now. Anyway, can I interest you in anything else?
Well, she offered it to him before, when he came in the shop, I think.
Some sort of wacky box with a smiley face on top. Never seen nothing like it. How about that peculiar looking box? The one with the smiley face?
Oh, right. Sorry, chap. That box is more important than you could possibly comprehend.
Really?
A true relic from another world. I only just managed to get all the ink off. Couldn't ever part with it.
Ink?
Oh, right you are.
Can I interest you in anything else?
There's a giant pig's head mounted to the wall. He looks happy. Ooh, can I have the giant pig's head?
That's not for sale, kid. Can I interest you in anything else?
Drat.
You can interest him in everything.
There's a scythe in the corner. Looks pretty new. That's neat. It folds up real small. You could almost fit it in a coat pocket. Oh, I want the sharp pointy thing. Can I have it, please?
A mighty fine choice, sir. Let me just check stock. Okay, look, we do have the stock. There's just one caveat.
Uh-oh.
Due to the nature of this item and following recent events involving a certain local businessman, I am unable to simply sell this to you. But if you were to, say, trade in another item in exchange for this, I would have no trouble parting with one.
What sort of thing are you looking for?
Mostly kitchenware, but we'll consider anything. Anything else take your fancy?
Kitchenware? I suppose you want a net.
Hey, look! I've got this really exciting tiny net! No, not interested. What do you want me to do? Stab him? Blimey.
I was gonna trade it for something.
As much as I'd love to poke him, I doubt they'll take kindly to it.
Alright, what about the box?
There's a fancy looking box over there.
Hey! Hands off! That ain't for sale.
Alright, so we can trade something for the scythe. I don't know why do we want it.
Munch, 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 munch.
Aww.
He says different things.
I'll leave him be. She looks pretty happy munching away on that grass. Must be tasty.
Pat, pat, pat.
Aww.
Munch, 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 munch.
Aww. I'll leave him be. Lots of tasty things start off growing in the dirt. Someone once told me that's where beer comes from. Still looking. Eh, I'll leave them. Most of these taste queer anyway.
So I can't select the bridge anymore.
It's full of a foul mixture of rotten vegetables and miscellaneous meat. I think I see some sprouts. And is that a finger? Ugh, gross. I'm not going fishing around in there. Ugh, gross.
We could use a net there.
I don't think the net's gonna help here.
Do we need a chicken?
I don't think so. I'll hold on to this for now.
Maybe the other chicken. What am I liking?
I don't think so.
Okay. And I think that's it. We can look at the lake.
Lake River Water. Next to the Great Forest, Treeswood. If you ever lose something down the privy, no doubt it'll turn up in River Water. I mean, I definitely can't fit a lake, mountain range, or 20-foot tree into my affinity pouch. Sure are a lot of shiny-looking weapons here. They're adorned with various intricate designs on the hilt.
Oi, keep your wee little hands off.
But they're so shiny.
You don't need your hands to look.
Fine. Coal, black and sooty. I don't fancy carrying around a lump of coal all day. Those coals are white hot. I'm not touching them. I don't think the net's gonna help here. I've seen those before. They pump air into the hot coals.
Keep your grubby hands off. That furnace is operating at a finely tuned temperature. I don't need pesky halflings messing it up.
Right, sorry about that.
Halfling.
He sure has a lot of tattoos.
Tattoos.
If you'd care to spare a minute, sir, I have a few questions.
Go on then, but be quick with it. I've got work to do.
We can actually talk to him. So what is it you do here exactly? Stupid question, but...
So what is it you do here exactly?
What kind of question is that?
A stupid
one. You blind or something?
I mean, clearly you make swords and stuff.
Aren't you a clever one? Yes, I make swords and stuff.
And other stuff?
Broadswords, halberds, spears, flail, battle axes, caltrops, daggers.
Shields?
Maces, crossbows, battens, mail, plate armor.
Wow, you sure are talented.
Someone's got to do some work around here.
What would it take to get one of those shiny swords?
So, what would it take to get one of those shiny new swords?
A lot more than you can afford, that's for sure.
Wah,
besides,
wah.
These are all made on commission. We don't do walk-ins.
I'll have you know, I work for the Wrinklewood Night's Watch.
You think I don't know that? Small town like this, Not a lot gets past me.
Hmm.
I also know you waste most of your wages over at the Drunken Monk, Tundbert.
I like to support local businesses.
Look, these swords ain't made for folk like you and me. Why don't you pop on down to Sam's? See if she's got something for you.
Just came from
Might
there.
Be a bit more in your price range.
I doubt it. Thanks for your time.
Be seeing you.
You haven't been there. Everything's reserved.
A variety of schematics for crafting arms. One for each of the houses of the Southern Kingdoms. What's all this about, then?
Leave me alone, would you?
A variety of tools used for metalwork, mostly hammers and tongs. I should ask the blacksmith if I want to borrow any of his tools. If you'd care to spare a minute, sir.
Go on, then.
Anything new? Yeah, we can't ask him for the tools.
Anything new to report?
I've told you all I know, mate. Be on your way. I'm busy here.
Stay vigilant, citizen.
You what?
Stay vigilant. And be on a still sky. One of the things they say a few times in that game.
Thanks for your time.
Be seeing you.
Alright. Now I think the only place we have left to go, well besides here, I will go check here and then I'll talk to what's his name at the guard post. Now that he'll be able to understand me.
Sorry, Tom, but can't let you pass.
I recognize me now.
Official tape. We use this stuff for doing official business. I'm not normally stuck on this side though. I don't think he's gonna let me take that tape.
Just like to hear the voice acting now that you can actually understand him.
There's a chair with the word director written on it. Must have fallen over. He's not going to let me take that. Besides, it's pretty big. Looks like the jester's hat. As much as I'd like a fancy hat with bells and that, I don't think he'll let me take it. A big fluffy thing on a stick. It looks nice and fluffy, but I don't think he'll let me take it.
Still think it's a boom mic.
That's the princess's guitar. He's not going to let me take it. Not that I have much use for a broken guitar.
Alright, so...
Birchwick looks pretty serious. Saying that, he always looks pretty serious. He doesn't look too happy. I'll leave him be.
Alright, we're off. Check in with what's his name?
Well, I'll be damned! Tomba!
Yeah!
No, that's more like it.
Can't believe I didn't recognize you for! How'd you mess up your face all like that?
Bees.
Ugh, I've had the worst day, Barrack.
Need somebody's ear to bend? I'm here all day.
Well, after what seemed like a fairly successful birthday shift, I thought it rude but not sample a few of the Drunken Monk's finer beverages.
Wise.
This led deep into the night until dawn, for when I thought it appropriate to retreat into my dorm at the castle spire. Unfortunately, it became apparent this morning that I was missing a few things, hence my appearance.
Oh, well, that's a mighty unlucky turn of events, son.
You're telling me.
On the plus side, though, things can't get much worse.
Guess not.
In fact, I got something that'll make them half inch better. Have a look in the chest.
Oh.
Key's hidden in the usual place.
Where's that? Tell me it's his tunic? I don't know what else we're looking for.
Welcome to Wrinklewood. Population 52. 52? Where are they all hiding?
This chest piece we're looking for, whatever they call it.
It's so big, I don't know where I'd put it. Ah, the great outdoors. Or so they say. I'm not going out there without good reason. Barrack's a good guy. He picks up after my shift. Sometimes we drink bourbon and watch the sunrise. I like Barrack.
It's good to see you looking better, Tondi.
Crank.
He looks a little cranky.
Hands off!
Well, you recognize me now.
All our storage chests are made of reinforced wrinklewood. It's locked tight. Barrack said the key is in the usual place.
Which is... where? Oh, the usual place.
The, usual place. Should be in here somewhere. Bingo.
Got a key.
Is the key to the amnesty chest?
What's the amnesty chest?
All our storage. Aha, so that's where it was.
Kept it safe for you, Tondi.
Found your shirt piece?
All our storage chest. Nothing else in there.
Yay, doublet.
My doublet and plate.
It's a little crowded here. I'd rather get changed somewhere more private.
I was afraid you were going to say that. Back to the farmland, maybe?
If you'll excuse me. Ta-da!
Finally. Go say thanks to Barrack.
It's good to see you looking better, Tondi.
Thanks.
Barrack's a good guy. Sometimes we only like Barrack. Nothing else in there.
Well, technically, I guess we could probably leave at this point. Let's go back to the castle. Bushy tree.
This tree is like 6 times my height. I can't take a tree with me.
You can't. It's awfully limiting.
This tree is like, Irvin always gets the best jobs. I'm sick of doing night shifts.
Hobbs, shiny shield with a heart as cold as steel.
He's always been a bit of an ass. It's a fine looking door.
Sorry about earlier, man. No feelings, eh?
Got to admit, you did look kind of messed up earlier, even for you.
Alright, well, what if we try to go back outside? I'm kind of curious. That save? Yeah.
I'm not going out there without good reason.
Not good reason?
The great outdoors, or so they say.
So before he wouldn't go out there because looking like that, now he won't go out without good reason. So the only thing left to do, as far as I know, is to check out in here.
This door leads to the front of the castle. This has been here for as long as I can remember. The Royal Coat of Arms. A cool sign for Wrinklewood's great heritage.
Sweet.
I've got no hope of picking that up. I'm not sure who could wield a shield that big. Well, apart from Dusty.
Oh yeah, Dusty's like a troll or something.
Fire, hot and burny. They made the candles out of beeswax, don't you know? I don't think my infinity pouch is fireproof. I'll leave it be.
Clerk. Castle Register.
The Castle Register. Keeps track of everything that comes in and out of the castle. Shame, can't make any sense of it from here. If I want to see the register, I should ask the clerk. Words don't make any sense from this angle.
Yeah, that's true.
That's the castle clerk. He keeps an eye on things. Hey there!
Ah, yes. Tonbert, isn't it?
That's me.
And how can I help you today, Tonbert?
Tell me everything you know about the castle.
So, tell me everything you know about the castle.
My pleasure. You've come to the right man. I've lived behind these walls since long before any of you folk were born. Simpler times they were.
How so?
Well, it was all bricks and mortar back in my day. None of these fancy flags and shiny floors.
Oh,
you
brother.
See, we weren't the first folk to live in Wrinklewood. Quite the opposite.
What do you mean?
Well, long before your king, there was another and another there before. The first king of Wrinklewood was nothing more than a bully and a thief. An entitled rich boy from the Seven Kingdoms who stopped at nothing to get what he desired. A man with absolutely no respect for those who came before him.
Oh, wow.
He raided the town and murdered its occupants, paving the way for his entitled regime.
Oops.
What was once a sacred house of worship became his home.
You mean the castle?
Exactly. He filled the halls with this cheap tat and paved over the entranceway to the catacombs.
You mean to say there are people buried underneath the castle?
Doesn't really feel right, does it? Anyway, he didn't last long. Was soon overthrown by one of the Alcafard brothers, Pembrim. Pembrim Alcafard was a wicked man. Much like his predecessor, he was interested in little but riches and wealth. Pembrim reigned over Wrinklewood for many years, as I sat by and watched what was once a beautiful civilized town become nothing more than another cog in the Alcafard war machine. That's why there's so many of you guards. After the war, there was nothing left to fight for. The Alcafard brothers had conquered the lands and left no stone unturned. Soon, Pembrim grew tired, disbanded his post, and set course back to the Seven Kingdoms. Of course, someone had to pick up the pieces. That's where Theodore came in.
King Theodore! Woo!
I couldn't have been happier when Theo took the reins. Such a kind fellow. He was exactly what this town needed.
That he is.
Wow.
I couldn't imagine a better man for the job.
Quite. I could certainly imagine a few worse. Well, I guess that's about it. Any questions?
Certainly a lot of background and lore. I like it. What do you know of the wildlands?
What do you know of the wildlands beyond the gates?
Only that which I've seen in my youth. There's the Elder Scar, formed thousands of years ago after the first fight of gods and men.
Gods and men.
The Deadwoods, a deep, sprawling maze of withered oak filled with unimaginable terrors. Not for the light of heart, I assure you. Beyond that is the Greater Northern Region. I've yet to meet any man who dare venture into those treacherous peaks.
The North remembers.
And I hear we now have an outbreak of Wrinkleworm, not far north of the town gates.
That doesn't sound good.
Wrinkleworm?
Ghastly things. Fully grown, they're the size of a house, with jaws the size of doors.
Should we not be a little concerned?
Not a lot we can do. Besides, it seems to have nested ready for the winter months.
Yikes, well, thanks. I'll be sure to give that one a miss.
Yeah.